Today's tutorial will be on development economics. We will continue our discussion with regard to neoclassical theory of growth. So we will be dealing with the solow model in this tutorial as well. And what we are going to do, we will see. So in today's tutorial, we'll actually see the impact of increase in savings rate. Now, to see the impact, that means we need to compare. So we will be considering at least 2 points so that comparison becomes very easy. Okay. Now, we already know that the capital per head as well as the income per head remain constant in the steady state when economy is growing at a rate of growth of population, or even you can call it to be labor force, and this is denoted by N. In other words, what we can say, in the steady state equilibrium, the change in capital per head delta represented by delta K is zero, and the change in Y, that is delta Y, is also zero. So what information we get from this, we understand from this that steady state growth rate, or you can also call it the long run growth rate, which is equal to population or labor force growth rate, N, so I'm writing within brackets, is not affected by changes in savings rate. So changes in saving rate affect only the short run growth rate of the economy, and this is an important implication of the neoclassical growth model. Now, there is a very interesting question that must be answered. That is, why do we get this apparent? So this is what is the general. We will definitely do the graphical representation, but let me talk about in terms of theory first. So apparently incredible result from the neoclassical theory. So, to answer this, we will first illustrate it graphically, and then we will move it, just transform the same thing in words. So, initially, the saving curve is given by SY, and the economy, so let us mark the intersection position. So, say, I'll mark it as T naught. I'll extend this. Okay. So the saving curve intersect this at T naught. These two curves intersect at T naught. And the capital per head is given by K star. And say the income per capita is given by, so it will be, we'll get this from YFK curve, so this is Y star. Okay, now suppose our savings rate increases. So what happens? This means that individuals, so let me write it. So saving rate increases means individuals in the society decide to save a higher fraction of income. As a result of this, our savings curve must shift to a higher position. So let us shift this savings curve first. So I'll shift it, and we will use dotted line to represent this. Okay. So it says something like this. Okay. So say I am denoting as S dash Y. Now the intersection point is here. So I am marking this as T1 K double star. And say, I'll extend this also. This point, and this is Y double star. Okay, so the higher savings curve denoted as S dash Y intersect N plus DK curve at point T1, which therefore represents the new steady state. We thus see that increase in savings rate has actually moves the steady state equilibrium, and this equilibrium have moved towards right. And one more impact is that it causes both capital per head as well as income per head to rise. And they have risen from K star to K double star. And for income per head is from Y star to Y double star respectively. What you should also note that in the new steady state, the economy grows at the same rate as the growth rate of labor force, or you can even call it to be population denoted by small n. So what it gives us, it actually denotes, or it therefore follows, that long run growth rate of the economy remains, the keyword to be used here is unaffected, by the increase in savings rate. Though the steady state position has actually moved to the right, which we have seen from point TO to T1. So there are two points that must be noted here. What are these two points? First, long run growth rate of the economy, as discussed earlier, remains the same as a result of increase in savings rate. And the capital per head and income per capita have risen with upward shift in the savings curve from SY to S dash Y, and consequently there has been a change in steady state, and this change can be denoted from T0 to T1. Capital per head has increased from K star to K double star, and similarly our income per head is increased from Y star to Y double star. So these are the changes that we have came across, or this is in summary, or the conclusion that we can draw. Now, in our next tutorial, I'll continue this discussion with regard to change in that has taken place due to change in savings rate, because there are more things that we need to unfold.